Have you hiked through a forest and noticed small hooked seeds clinging onto your pants or backpack? Well, congratulations, you may have just helped the forest grow a little. Every plant that produces seeds must find a way to spread those seeds, preferably to a place that's far from the parent plant where there's enough space, sunlight, water, and nutrients. Once the seed lands on such a spot, it can grow into a brand new adult plant. So who moves the seeds? Since most plants can't move by themselves, they've developed strategies to make others do the job for them. Some plants produce very light seeds, which the wind can blow away and spread around. For many other plant species, animals and birds are key to dispersing their seeds. This is known as zoochory. Remember those small hooked seeds sticking to your hiking pants? Many plant species have evolved to produce seeds in fruits that can attach or get entangled in an animal's fur or body. Some of these seeds or fruits have hooks, spines, or barbs. Others have adhesive mucus. Once these attach to the body of an unsuspecting animal, bird, or human, or even car tires or footwear, the seeds and fruits can get dispersed over long distances. The thing with this kind of dispersal mechanism is that the plants don't really advertise their fruits or seeds. Instead, they seem to depend on animals randomly brushing past them and taking their seeds along for a ride. But many plant species don't want to wait for chance passers-by. They actively try to get animals to come to them and take their seeds away. One way to achieve this is by surrounding their seeds in colorful, fragrant, nutritious, fleshy or dry fruits that entice animals. For example, bears gorge on bilberries and raspberries, hornbills enjoy figs, and Asian elephants are fond of big elephant apples. The animal, while eating the fruit, might spit out the seed or regurgitate it after a while. Or the animal could eat the fruit whole and let the seed pass through its digestive tract. If the seed survives this journey and eventually comes out in the animal's droppings or feces, and if the conditions are right, it could germinate and grow into a new individual. In a tropical Congo forest, for example, researchers found that 85% of the 700 plant species they identified produce fleshy fruits and depend on animals like forest elephants, bonobos, monkeys, mangabeys, bats, hornbills, and civets for seed dispersal. In fact, a wide range of animals and birds help distribute fruit seeds this way. Corvids, parrots, macaws, and lizards do it. Even some fish are known to eat fruits of plants growing in streams and marine bays. When they poop out the seeds, they help the plant spread out. Sometimes the fruit isn't what attracts an animal. It's the seed that's the prize. Remember Scrat, the saber-toothed squirrel from the Ice Age movies obsessed with trying to hide his acorn? Even today, the sight of squirrels running around with nuts and seeds in their mouths looking for a place to hide their stash is common. Several other rodents like black rats and wood mice collect seeds, as do birds like jays, hooded crows, and magpies. For these animals, the seeds themselves are attractive food sources that they can cache away for a long time. But hoarding comes with its own problems. Sometimes the animals don't remember where some of their stash is located, or they store more than they can consume, or they may die before recovering their precious seed or nut. The seeds that get left behind uneaten now have a chance to grow into a new plant. How do plants ensure that the seed predators leave some seeds uneaten? Researchers say that in some cases, they do it by producing large, attractive, nutritious seeds that animals feel tempted to hoard. Sometimes plants like some pines and oaks prompt hoarding by masting. That is, they produce a lot of cones or seeds every few years. So animals are forced to store much more than they can consume, and a few invariably remain uneaten. But why disperse seeds at all? Researchers say it helps plants avoid overcrowding so that access to adequate food, water, and sunlight isn't an issue for both the growing saplings and the parent plant. Spreading the seeds far away also prevents a plant's population from becoming restricted to just a few spots. When seeds from one plant grow too close together, it can lead to genetic inbreeding and make it harder for the species to fight diseases, pathogens, or climate change. So when animals like elephants are hunted for their tusks, or when monkeys, tapirs, or birds are trapped for the wildlife trade, it's not just the animals themselves that are affected. The plant species that depend on them for the dispersal of their seeds suffer too. A recent study, for instance, found that lowland tapirs move around a ton of seeds in their poop in degraded Amazonian forests. Elephants, because of their long-distance seed-dispersing capabilities, are referred to as the mega-gardeners of forests in Africa and Asia. So zoo quarry is essential for many plants to survive. Think about that the next time you notice seeds clinging onto your pants when you're out for a walk.